Before we begin our video worship this morning, I want to encourage you to please get access to our Sunday bulletin so that you can participate in the service. You may find it at www.ccqf.org. Just look under the tab for May 10th and you'll see bulletin. And please either make a copy of it or have your computer open to it so that you can join with us in worship. To Christ belongs the victory, the majesty, and the power, for he has risen from the dead and trampled Satan under his feet. Good morning and welcome to Christ Church Quaker Farms on May 17th for the sixth Sunday of Easter, and a special welcome for those of you who are visitors and guests and friends. Thank you for joining us for this time of worship and learning and praise. Our service will begin on your bulletins, page 3. If you don't have a bulletin, you can just do the people's response after me, which I will be leading as well. Hallelujah! Christ is risen! The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah! The angels said, Jesus isn't here. And the people, he has been raised from the dead. Now go, tell his disciples that. For the people, Jesus is alive. Hallelujah! The Lord be with you and also with you. Let us pray the collect of the day, saying, Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that as we believe your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to have ascended into heaven, so we may also in heart and mind, there ascend with him, where he continually dwells, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Now I invite you to stand and join us in singing the opening hymn, Come Ye Faithful, Raise the Strain. The words will appear on the video itself. Thank you.
The first reading is from the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verse 10, chapter 22, verses 1 through 5. And the angel carried me away in the spirit to a mountain great and high, and showed me the holy city, Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God. The main street of the city was pure gold, translucent as glass, but there was no sign of a temple, for the Lord God, the Sovereign Strong, and the Lamb are the temple. The city doesn't need sun or moon for light. God's glory is its light, the Lamb its lamp. The nations will walk in its light, and earth's kings bring in their splendor. Its gates will never be shut by day, and there won't be any night. They'll bring the glory and honor of the nations into the city. Nothing dirty or defiled will get into the city, and no one who defiles or deceives, only those whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life will get in. Then the angel showed me Water of Life River, crystal bright. It flowed from the throne of God and the Lamb right down the middle of the street. The tree of Lamb was planted on each side of the river, producing 12 kinds of fruit, a ripe fruit each month. The leaves of the tree are for healing the nations. Never again will anything be cursed. The throne of God and of the Lamb is at the center. His servants will offer God service, worshiping. They'll look on his face, their foreheads mirroring God. Never again will there be any night. No one will need lamplight or sunlight. The shining of God, the Master, is all the light anyone needs. And they will rule with him age after age after age. The word of the Lord.
This reading is taken from the book of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 7. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you're going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him.
Philip said, Lord, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus answered, Don't you know me, Philip, even after I have been among you such a long time? Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Don't you believe that I am in the Father and that the Father is in me? The words I say to you I do not speak on my own authority. Rather, it is in the Father, living in me, who is doing his work. Believe me when I say that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me, or at least believe on the evidence of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, whoever believes in me will do the works I have been doing, and they will do even greater things than these, because I am going to the Father. And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Okay, we thank Kim for reading that reading. We now have the optional time where parents can discuss the reading with their children. There are questions and activities on the bulletin, page 2, and we invite you to pause if you like, or you can do it later on, whatever you prefer. But let's pray before the sermon. Almighty Jesus, after you rose from the dead, you ascended to heaven, where you created a place for us to dwell with you and the Father. Grant that our hearts and minds would ascend to heaven with you, that we would live within your Father's house, now and forever. Amen. Amen. So a priest and a crazy taxi driver died and they arrived at the pearly gates at the same time. St. Peter was there and he greeted them, and then he took the taxi driver to his new home, which was an incredible mansion. Just 30 rooms, beautiful grounds, an Olympic-sized pool, tennis courts, bowling alley, and the taxi driver was just overwhelmed, and he said, "Thank you. Thank you, St. Peter. I don't deserve this, but I appreciate it." Then St. Peter took the priest, and he got this broken down old shack with a bunk bed and an old TV. And the priest said, "St. Peter, I'm confused. I'm a priest. I went to church every day and I preached the gospel. I should deserve the mansion and not the taxi driver." And St. Peter replied to the priest, "Yes, but when you preached, people fell asleep. When the taxi driver drove, all those people prayed." Here we go. This is where you laugh. All right. There we go. Now, I wonder how many of you before the pandemic did any planning? Would you plan for what you were going to do in the day, or plan for what was going to go on in the week, or in the month, or in the years ahead? I wonder, likewise, if you made plans for school or vacation or work or whatever. Now think about the time and the energy that goes into planning temporal things. And how does that compare to the work and planning that we undertake for going to heaven? Most people can't even imagine eternity. I have here a ball of string. And the first 8 inches of this string is colored red, and it represents our lives on earth, from birth to death, all 8 inches colored red. And the rest of this string represents eternity. And eternity goes on for a long time. Eternity goes, the ball of string represented, it goes out that door, down past Florida, down to the South Pole, up around China, up around the North Pole, back to Oxford, and it wraps around the world 8 million times. That's eternity. You see, 72% of people believe in eternity and go, and they want to go to heaven. But I don't know how many of them really know that they're going to heaven. Do you want to go to heaven? If so, you are in for a real treat. I read a description of heaven this past week, and it made me salivate. It made me want to go and book reservations right away, and I'm going to share that with you. If you would look at that written in your bulletin, you can follow along with me as I read the description of heaven. Here's what the author says. "The most important thing about heaven is that it is far more glorious than anything you could ever imagine. When God gave the Apostle John a glimpse of Jesus' glory in heaven, John was so overwhelmed that he fell at his feet as though dead. One reason that heaven is so glorious is because it's absolutely perfect. In this present world, we are surrounded by sin, decay, and death, but that won't be true in heaven. This world is racked by violence and wars and natural disasters, but again, that will not be true in heaven. The Bible says, "Nation will not take up sword against nation, nor will they train for war anymore." But heaven is glorious most of all because it is the dwelling place of God. We can barely imagine this, but it's true. The Bible says, "Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them." Will heaven be like this world? The Bible says that in some ways it will be. We won't feel like strangers. We'll finally be home. But in other ways, heaven will be more wonderful and perfect beyond measure. Why would anyone not want to go there? The greatest fact about heaven, however, is that we can go there. Only one thing keeps you out of heaven, and that is your sin. But Jesus came to open up heaven's door for us, and he did this by taking the judgment upon himself that we deserve. So why not put your faith in him today? So that is a beautiful overview of heaven. But I want to share with you, for me, what are the four most glorious parts of heaven. And they're encapsulated in four words. And the first word is, hallelujah! Would you join me in saying that? Hallelujah! Hallelujah means praise the Lord, and that is the quintessential word for worship in the New Testament and in the Old Testament. Worship is all about praising the Lord. Praising the Lord is what biblical worship is all about. From today's reading describing worship in heaven, the throne of God and the Lamb, who is Jesus, will be at the center. His servants will worship him, and they will see his face. Now, this will not be hymnal and prayer book worship as much as some of us, including me, love our worship traditions. No, this worship will be Holy Spirit inspired. Joyful, participatory, spontaneous worship as we express our love to God from the depths of our hearts. According to the Bible, we'll sing such songs as these: Hallelujah! Salvation and glory and power belong to our God. And likewise, Hallelujah! For the Lord God Almighty reigns. We will hear the word of God straight from his mouth, and it will be electrifying. The Bible says that God's voice is joyful. It's like many running waters. It's like thunder. It's like a blast of the trumpet. You will be there and hear him right through yourself. And you know, there's not going to be any sleeping there in those sermons in heaven, I'll tell you. So heaven is characterized first by hallelujah worship, and secondly, heaven is characterized by perfect harmony. Harmony. No wars, no pretension, no fights, no arguments, no selfish ambition, no prejudice, no cursing one another, no attitude. Heaven is for the peace-loving, and heaven is populated by peace-loving people. One image of heaven that really attracts me is the idea of the heavenly minister of music leading a choir of 1 million voices. all singing together in beautiful harmony. Heaven is for harmony. Heaven is for harmony. Hallelujah. And next, heaven is for healing. Perfect healing. You know, the Bible in our New Testament reading says today that the tree of life in heaven has leaves of healing for one and all. Imagine a universe where we are free of sickness, free of injury, free of disease, pandemic, free of injury and pain. A world where our bodies are renewed and made whole and perfect. Imagine no dying or worrying about dying, no mourning. Imagine that for all the suffering you have encountered on earth, you will receive heavenly treasure in compensation. Who knows what that's like, but it sounds pretty great to me. And imagine being in heaven where you have the power and the will to forgive those who have hurt you. And imagine Jesus coming to you, as the Bible says, and wiping away every tear of sorrow and holding you and hugging you until you feel his comfort to your bones. Wow. So heaven is hallelujah, heaven is harmony, heaven is healing, and heaven is home, our eternal home. Heaven is our perfect home, as described in today's gospel, God's house with many places to live in for us. There we will meet old friends. There we will make new friends who all share the same values and faith as we do. We will join together in the fellowship of the communion of saints, all those God-loving men and women throughout the past, and you can bet they will have some stories to tell. I want to talk to Abe Lincoln first. I want to find out stuff from him. So what is heaven like? Hallelujah, harmony, healing, and home. And there we will reign. We will co-reign with Christ as co-heirs with him through baptism. So, we understand clearly that God wants all people to come to heaven. But do you know how? Does your family know how? Do your friends know how? Come back next week and we will talk about that. But in the meantime, I'd like you to stand and to turn in your bulletin to page 3, where we're going to hear Caitlin Wentz sing a beautiful song about heaven, and you can join in the chorus.
Stand in your presence until my knees will have can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine.
Congregation of Christ Church Quaker Farms, grant that we may shine your light by loving all the people as you love us. Risen Lord, hear our prayer. Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in your ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Risen Lord, hear our prayer. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, especially those frightened by and suffering from the coronavirus. Give them courage and hope in their troubles and bring them the joy of your salvation. Risen Lord, hear our prayer. We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. We pray that we and they may share with all the saints of light in your eternal kingdom. Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks that you have preserved us unto this new day by your grace and by your mercy. And Lord, it is through you that we have life. And we claim that breath of life to be breathed in us anew, that we might live in the joy of your Spirit and in the joy of your resurrection. Lord, we lift up to you all those who are in need of your care. We remember especially our parish nurses and medical personnel. We remember those in our parish who have to work in dangerous situations that are contagious. We ask that you protect them and heal them. We remember, Lord, all those of our parish who are unemployed or underemployed. We ask that you would provide for their needs out of your riches and glory. And now, Lord, let us pray together in the words our Savior Christ has taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. I now invite you all to stand, and we're going to exchange the peace with one another. Some of us are sitting with family members and others are not. For those of us who are alone, you can exchange the peace with Jesus by making the peace sign, and I will exchange it with you. So, may the peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Now exchange the peace. And now let us with gladness present the offering of our life and our labor unto the Lord. You know, there are some pastors who say that you gotta give until it hurts. But that's not what we say at Christ Church Quaker Farms. We say we want you to give till it feels good, because the Lord loves a cheerful giver. And if you want to give to Christ Church and you're not sure how to do it, we encourage you to go back to our webpage, and there you will see a green button on the right side, and you can give online. And we thank all of our members who provide most of what we need to keep going. But if our guests and visitors would like to contribute, we would thank you as well. And now, if you would repeat with me, all good things come from you, O Lord. All good things come from you, O Lord. And from what you've given, we give back to you. And from what you've given, we give back to you. And may Jesus Christ, who rose from the dead, trampling down evil under his feet, bestow upon you the blessings of his resurrection. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and upon those you love, now and forever. Amen. And now, if you would stand, we're going to sing our concluding hymn, which is, the words will be on the screen again, Through the Red Sea by Adam Cowell, the organist at our sister mother church, St. Peter's. When you look on page 4, each year Christ Church does something to honor our graduating seniors, and we want to do something this year as well. That is in the plans. It's going to be a surprise. We will be announcing it soon. But we need to know who our seniors are or who our graduates are. So on page 4 or on our Facebook page, you can see the information we need. And if you would just send that to Christ Church, ccqf@att.net, we will be happy to honor your grad, be they from nursery school or be they from graduate school. And now if you would turn to the bottom of page 4 for the dismissal. Let us go forth in the protection and power of Jesus Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. And joining with me, say, thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Have a blessed week, everybody. See you next Sunday.